Now let us study about the general methods of preparation of glycols. The first type is by addition reactions, under which dihydroxylation is an important method. Dihydroxylation involves the action of cold dilute alkaline potassium permanganate solution, which is known as Bayer's reagent, on olefins diols are formed. This type of ethene is taken and is oxidized in the presence of water to form a glycol. Second is by the addition of oxygen to form olefin oxide from olefin, followed by acid hydrolysis to give glycol. Ethene is taken and thus added half moles of oxygen to form an olefin oxide, where it is a cyclic compound. On further hydrolysis, that is H3O plus denotes acidic hydrolysis, thus results in the formation of glycols. Thus ethylene forms ethylene epoxide in the presence of Ag and at about 473 to 673 Kelvin. Similarly, the product thus formed is hydrolyzed to ethylene glycol by addition of dilute hydrochloric acid or even sulfuric acid at 333 Kelvin. This reaction proceeds via the nucleophilic attack by water at the protonated epoxide. Third method is that olefins are firstly converted to chlorohydrins and are then hydrolyzed with milk of lime. Milk of lime is nothing but calcium hydroxide. Ethylene glycol itself is prepared as follows. CH2CH2 is added by thionyl chloride. It produces CH2OH CH2Cl. On further addition of milk of lime, that is CaOH twice, we obtain the product CH2OH CH2OH, which is nothing but ethylene glycol. In the above step, the first step involves the addition of across a double bond on, and the second step an SN2 mechanism where the OH replaces the Cl here. The latter two methods are of commercial importance. SN2 is nothing but the replacement of one ion by the other. Second D is by substitution reactions. 1,2 dihaloalkanes are hydrolyzed with aqueous sodium carbonate. But let us study about ethylene dibromide. It is firstly heated with moist silver oxide or aqueous sodium carbonate solution to form ethylene glycol. For example, let us take bromomethyl. On addition of water and sodium carbonate, we obtain methanol, because the OH groups present in water replaces the bromine ions. And further, we get sodium bromide and carbon dioxide as side product. Even this reaction involves SN2 mechanism by OH minus, and the leaving group here is the bromine ions from bromomethyl. Secondly is by action of nitrous acid on ethylene diamine leads to ethylene glycol. Let us take this example, ethamine. On addition of 2 moles of nitrous acid, we obtain methanol and thus nitrogen and water as a side products. An unstable diazonium ion is formed in the first step, which undergoes nucleophilic attack by OH minus group to form glycol. Third is by reduction reactions. This procedure is similar to the preparation of alcohol by Boole-Planck reduction, where aldehyde or ketone or even esters can be reduced to alcohol by sodium and ethanol. Thus, ethylene glycol is prepared from diethyl oxalate. In this following reaction, ethyl acetylate on addition of 8 moles of hydrogen forms methanol and 2 moles of ethanol. On further reaction with four hydrogen molecules, we obtain methanol, which can also be brought back by reverse reaction by glycolic aldehyde.